Yo, what is going on, homies? It's your boy Stumped back for another OBTC video, and in today's video, we are over here on the global side of the game with the new treasure map, Koala, that has literally just released. So we will be testing the teams that I did put together in the prep video and seeing how they operate. Now, I am going to let you guys know there is subject to change. As I did get information that Cavendish doesn't give cooldowns, then that way I had just swapped basically Blackbeard and Miguel and Moria. That's basically all I did. And I think I actually replaced Blackbeard as a captain, and I use Magellan just because we have color affinity that way. But there are a couple of things we are going to talk about as we make our way through the map. And there are a couple of things that I will be changing as the treasure map does get harder and harder. With this new treasure map structure, this was like the start of like a bit of a change on Japan. The first boss that we normally use Buggy for does get a little bit harder. So the Buggy team will be subject to change. I'll most likely bring in Bonnie as the captain when that does happen. But look, it's still the first fight. It's still not going to be that tricky to get around. And for the meantime, we just want to try and get it done as quickly as possible. And we are going to make use of Buggy. Another thing to note is too, on the fight that... Look, I'll talk about it when we actually get there. That's probably a little bit easier. So let's get this Sabo intrusion battle going, and then we can actually just go from there. So if you guys are enjoying today's video, though, don't forget to go down there and smash the like button for me if you're new to the channel too. Hit that big red subscribe button as well. But we are here, and Sabo has finally intruded. And the recommended team for this particular setup is actually utilizing Law. Now, because Sabo is a quick unit, we are going to bring a friend Shirahoshi. That way we can actually just get the most of the drops, or the most of the points, I should say. As Shirahoshi only boosts Dex characters, so that way we can just get Lore popping off a little bit stronger. Now, I do have the support of, what's his name? Sengoku on Lore. That's literally just so we can just get some more damage going. On turn one, we do come up against Jesus Burgess, who actually gives us 3 turns of an orb boost. And then on turn, 4 turns. And then on turn two, we come up against Lindbergh. Now, Lindbergh's going to give us a full board of block orbs and put up defense up. So this is where Reiju's really, really good. Now, if you guys don't have Reiju, Reiju's going to extend the orb buff as well. She's just an absolute weapon for this particular fight and actually helps out quite a lot. After we've done that, we're basically just going to tap our way through, and we should be able to take out Lindbergh, no issues whatsoever, because we do have that Rainbow Orbis, which is actually really, really handy, as once we hit the final stage against Sabo, we can actually only use, like, 2 specials, I think it is, and because Sabo actually binds our top row, as well as, like, I'm pretty sure he despairs us as well. Does he despair us as well? I'm pretty sure he does that. Yeah, he despairs us as well. We really need that Rebecca special. You could easily use the support of Corazon on Lore here. That way you can get around that, and you can actually use the special of Shiryu here. So that way you've got color affinity as well. That is another option for you guys. And I would highly recommend doing that if you are missing the Reiju to extend that orb buff, as it will be a little bit annoying to actually get around that. But as you can see, Lore's just going to do so much damage with his damage buff, his attack, 2.75 times attack, the 1.5 extra damage. And then with the extra chain buff that Sengoku can provide, we are going to be in really good stead. So this team's not going to struggle at all. Once it does get a little bit harder, I probably will change that support from Sengoku to Corazon. That way I can actually get access to the Shiryu color affinity for slashes and drivens. And with that, we can just do more damage. So I'm going to fast forward now to the final mini boss stages, and I will see you guys there. All right, so we very slowly made our way around the map. And I don't know if that's just because I'm used to the new structure of Japan, where you can actually just get around the map in like 20 stamina. But it took us 72 stamina to get all the way around the map. But look, it is what it is. On the first fight, we come up against Carousel. Now, this is where I am using double Buggy. I did get reports that the Carousel's HP pool is actually a lot higher than what the normal mini boss HP actually is. And for this particular team to work as well as it does, we do have the support of Rayleigh on our Luffy. That way, we don't have to worry about getting the super switch of Law and Chopper. But if you do have, if you don't have the Rayleigh support for Luffy, the free-to-play one that actually you got as a login bonus for the start of this celebration, you can actually just get the super switch, and it should work really, really nicely. As I was saying, once this does start to get a little bit harder, I will probably replace Buggy with something like Bonnie. That way I can still utilize the kid ability of just wiping through these stages very, very easily. The ability to use kid, even if he's not a booster, it just helps out so much, as we don't actually have to worry about sort of like tapping through, and we can just like mindlessly single tap, kill all those mobs, and then get to the final stage, which in this case is against Carousel. Now, against Carousel, he's going to give us a full board of unfavorable slots. He's going to paralyze us and despair us for 5 turns, respective to your sockets. Then what we can do here is we can use the special of Law to remove the paralysis, but ideally, we just want to go Big Mom special and actually kill here. And Bob's your uncle, see you later, Carousel. Like I said, he does have a lot more HP than normal, then the normal mini bosses just get absolutely clapped there. But you can also use stuff like treasure map animals, very, very good. But as you can see, we have Law and Chopper to remove the paralysis. And then with Luffy, we can actually rotate our orbs, get an orb buff. And then with Boggy, we have an attack boost as well. So nevertheless, we are going to be in good stead. Big Mom can rotate orbs as well. So that team shouldn't struggle like for a little bit longer. But once it does, I will just sort of bring Bonnie into play and then just sort of start clapping with Bonnie, as Bonnie can give a lot more points and still use the kid ability. Moving on to the next fight now, we come up against Bello Betty. Now, against Bello Betty, this is the one that I did change. I did change Moria from my captain to Magellan, and I did bring in Usopp and Chopper, mainly because they have color affinity. The recommended characters are obviously Urogue. Urogue, Katakuri, and the Usopp and Chopper. So they work very, very nicely to take this fight down. However, against one of the other mini bosses, I cannot remember who it is. I know Shiryu is the recommended character. Urogue actually works really, really nicely, mainly because Urogue can actually get around the removed sound effects. But for this particular team, because Magellan is technically a rainbow captain, we can actually use Young Shinobu. Young Shinobu works very, very similarly to the Kazuna Kid, where for 3 turns, she is going to do end of turn damage, and if you have above 41% of your HP, which you normally do at the start of the fight after using her special, you can actually get her cooldowns reduced by 7 turns. Once we've done that, once we hit the 4th stage, again, she's going to have our special ready to go. We can literally just use her special again. We can single tap, and we are basically going to be in good stead. Because she's 3 turns of end of turn damage as well, we can actually carry it into the boss fight, which is really, really nice. It's just going to give us a little bit of extra damage if we are struggling to output as much damage as we actually need. But against Bello Betty, she's really not that tricky. She does have Threshold, and that's why Urogue is actually really, really good for this fight, because he can remove that Threshold. But as long as you bring anyone to remove Threshold, like, you are going to be fine. We do have Magellan here to give ourselves the poison. You can use the support of Hannibal for a conditional boost as well, which is really, really cool. You can also get a chain lock with Katakuri. You can rotate those orbs into matching from those block orbs as well. And then we can actually just get the orb boost through the Usopp and the Chopper dual unit. And with that, just like, she's going to absolutely melt poor Bello Betty. We have the color affinity from Magellan as well, which is great. And you can actually get that 2.5 times attack boost with Magellan over Urogue. But in the early stages, I'm just going to use Urogue because it's just a lot easier. And with that, we can just tear through it. So this team's going to work really nicely. Another sort of like fast, mindless tapping team with the help of Young Shinobu, of course, who is boosted. Obviously, she is the newest arena character. So make sure to farm her up if you guys haven't done so already, because she's very, very good. And she's going to be really, really good in most treasure maps moving forward. Moving on to the Morley stage now. This is the one that I was actually talking about. Urogue is actually really, really good for this particular fight because you do get removed sound effects. Now, if you have a look here, that removed sound effects debuff can actually like cuck a lot of players. And he actually has a barrier, which makes it very, very hard. Now, if you guys don't have the Bonnie Batch are really, really good for this because you can actually get around those defects. But the way that I'm actually doing it is I'm actually bringing Law. Now, if you have a friend captain Law and build the team around sort of like cerebrals and slashes, it will work really, really nicely. And the reason it works nicely is because Law has barrier pen. Otherwise, you can also use stuff like the Aura Jackson. The Aura Jackson is going to help out a lot because you can make it easier to hit perfects. But in the early fights, in the early stages, like treasure map runs I'm talking about here, we can just use Law's barrier pen to just tear through it. Once it does get a little bit trickier, I will bring Urogue onto the team. He's a dex unit, so he can just slide straight in. And with the ship cooldowns, the 5 turns, as well as the boosted units, we can actually get Bone Kichi special ready to go at the beginning. Bone Kichi, again, does end of turn damage, just like Young Shinobu, just like Kid. And we can actually just stage wipe. And then when we hit stage 4, we can use our treasure map Zoro special, even though he's not boosted. I don't really care. Like, I just want to tear through these as quickly as possible. He has double special as well, so ideally you could just use him on turn 3 and turn 4, and then move into the final stage against Morley. Now, Morley gives us attack down for 5 turns, which is a little bit annoying because Shiryu only removes 4 turns. Shiryu is going to give us color affinity as well, but if you run like a Shiryu friend captain, you can obviously remove the rest of that. But if you have Basil Hawkins like myself, you can actually use Basil Hawkins to remove the attack down. I'm sure there's probably like a support that you guys can use as well. I'm pretty sure there's a Frankie support. I'm not sure if he'll work on like many of these characters. He might actually go on Bone Kichi Brook, and you can save that special for the end. But as you can see here, like, once we just use all our specials, like, we've pretty much torn him down, and then Law can literally just like go through the barrier, and it's gonna work really, really nicely. I've obviously used more specials than I need to there, but once sort of things start to pick up, like, we are going to be in really, really good stead there. So that team's not going to struggle. Once it does, and if you guys are struggling, just put Urogue on that team, as you don't really need Urogue for the threshold. There are other boosters that can remove that, namely like the rare recruit. what's his name? Aokiji, he can remove that. And I'm pretty sure there's another free-to-play character on the list that can remove the threshold as well. So that's another option for you guys if you're struggling with the remove sound effects. The final boss, mini-boss, is actually Ivankov. Now, I did get confirmation that you need to heal to get the cooldown for Cavendish. So I actually made Moria my captain here. Now, the downside to this particular team is I don't have a way of actually making it like just mindless tapping. So what I'm actually going to do here, I'm going to bring a powerhouse Dex Kaido captain, friend captain. Now, this is not exactly the fastest way to run treasure map, but with myself, like when it comes to treasure map, I just like to make it as easy as possible for myself. And the easiest way to do that is literally just to bring a Kaido friend captain. Because Kaido's powerhouse as well, you can actually still get the super typing of Moria. And if you guys are unaware, Moria's super typing will actually give cooldowns to driven and powerhouse characters. That way, when we get the special reverse, we don't have to worry about like healing back with these like 10 meat orb stuff, and you will be fine. Another option here is to bring Bonnie as your captain. And then with Bonnie as your captain, you can use her super typing to get cooldowns and then use her special to get cooldowns as well. I think she has the sailor ability though that actually reverses special rewind. So you could also use something like that and just bring her as a sub to get around that. But the recommended characters are Bardo and Cavendish. But once we hit the final stage against Ivankov, he's actually not only going to roll our specials backwards. Oh, that's a good point. I can't use the Big Mom Kaido special now because our captain gets blinded. Interesting. So I'm going to have to try and find a way. I'll probably slide Bonnie onto this particular team over Blackbeard. You can, if you have the Lafitte support though, you could easily use the Lafitte support on Blackbeard there to remove two turns of the bind. Okay, so that's a little bit of an issue. But look, that's why we make these videos, right? The beautiful thing is we still have Kaido as a friend captain, and in the early stages, we can do something like that. So Lafitte support's going to be really, really good there, as he can remove two turns of blind and despair when inflicted if you are using the Blackbeard. I'll probably try and do something like that. Otherwise, you can always use something like Bonnie. Bonnie will give the cooldowns as well. But it is two turns of cooldown, so that is also something to note. Very, 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 very interesting there. But like I said, if you bring a Kaido friend captain, you are going to be fine there. I will have a look at some supports to actually get around that. Like I said, Lafitte's very, very good. And while we're here, actually, let's just quickly do that. Let's see. We've got the Lafitte support there. Bardo Cavendish, Big Mom Kaido. Does Big Mom and Kaido have a bind remover that they can work with? I know they'd have one on specials, but I'll have to have a little bit of a look into that. If you guys know any, please let me know in the comment section below, as it'll save me a little bit of time and hopefully help other players out as well. But let's move on to the Koala boss fight now. The final boss fight, the recommended legend is the new Bounce Man Luffy. So if you guys don't have Luffy, just probably bring a friend captain, I would say. I'm going to be bringing a Rebecca friend because, like, obviously she boosts quick. Now, the character you really need for this particular fight is Zoro. Now, if you guys don't have the new rare recruit Zoro, it may be a little bit tough, but don't stress. There are some other characters you guys can use. To get around the attack down on the final stage, you can actually bring the new Koala. The new Koala, if you guys aren't unaware, for three turns, she makes you immune to attack down. So you can easily use her special on turn four. That way you're immune to attack down. And when you move into the final stage, you can actually just bypass it. She's also a free spirit. So if you have Luffy, you can easily slide her on the team over something like Shirahoshi. Now, you will lose points, obviously, because you'd still need to bring a special bind remover. In the early stages, you might not need the special bind removal because she's an attack booster and you can carry those across. But other special bind removers include the rare recruit Luffy. He's another boosted unit. And I'm pretty sure there's something like, you've also got units like the free-to-play Vasco Shot and some of those other batches there as well. So they should all work very nicely. But once we hit the stage four, we come up against Hack. Hack has damage reduction. So again, Reiju is really, really good here. Any character that can remove five turns of damage reduction will work. There is the rare recruit Sengoku. I'm pretty sure he works fine. And once we've done that, we can sort of just kill Hack, like no issues whatsoever. You could use the super typing of Luffy there, I guess, like that just for a little bit more damage if you need it once things start to get a little bit harder. Or you can use like a support to give you a little bit more damage as well. Obviously, with two Luffys, you can use a Luffy special there and that should work absolutely fine. As you guys can see, though, we do get the attack down. We do get the special bond on our captains. So you really don't even really need the special bond, to be honest, especially in the early stages, because like Luffy is going to give an attack buff. But as long as you bring like another character that can just like do something that's really helpful, like the Usopp Chopper, giving you guys just a little bit of an extra buff and getting around that attack down. Like I said, Koala is an attack booster as well. So like you could just like use that attack booster in the early stages and just take through those, move through those fights until you need another special. But that's going to wrap up today's video, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the playthrough. If you did, make sure to go in there and belt the like button for me if you're new to the channel. Hit that big red subscribe subscribe button too. But guys, wherever you are in this beautiful world, please remember to enjoy the rest of your day. As always, homies, I thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Later!